Welcome to the October recap of the 2015 Lumberjacks season. You're watching Logged In. The Jacks started October with a trip to Edmonton to play in the Challenge Cup. Taking place from October 11th to the 13th, the Challenge Cup pits the five best HPL teams from BC against the five best HSL teams from Alberta and Saskatchewan. At last year's Challenge Cup, the Jacks went undefeated and took home the championship. Would the team be able to defend their title and repeat? Challenge accepted. Just like last year's tournament, the round robin kicked off with a morning game against the HSL Warriors. The Jacks struggled in their first game, with the kids not connecting and flowing like they have been recently. Pulling out a 6-3 win, the team regroups to prepare for the afternoon game. The afternoon game of October 11th saw the Jacks taking on the 0-2 Grizzlies back at West Edmonton Mall's Ice Palace. With the sun shining through the venue's glass dome and making it difficult to see at times, the team started to find their footing and took the game 7-0 to finish the opening day of the tournament. On the morning of October 12th, the team played their third game of the tournament against the North Stars at the Silent Ice Center. While getting off to a bit of a rough start, the kids started to find their rhythm by the second period and finished the game strong. In the final game of the preliminaries, the Jacks faced the Queen City Young Guns, a first-year HSL team from Saskatchewan. Riding high from the success of their morning game against the North Stars, the team started off strong and ended with an 8-1 victory. This put the team in first place in the BC division at the end of the round robin and advanced the team to the semifinals with a matchup against the Beavers. The semifinals would pit the top two HPL teams against each other in the BC division to face the winner of the top two HSL teams in the Alberta division. The Jacks stormed out of the gate against the Beavers, scoring four goals in the first period and winning the game 8-1, setting up a championship game matchup with Spartan Hockey Academy. Like last year's Challenge Cup final, the Lumberjacks would face off against Spartan Hockey Academy. After five games in 3 days, the kids gave everything they had in the sixth and final game of the tournament to win 8-0 and take the Challenge Cup championship for the second year in a row. The team outscored their opponents 57-7, with Zhang posting two shutouts and a .903 save percentage. Eckford tied for first in overall points in the tournament with 9 goals and 9 assists. Novak finished close behind with 9 goals and 8 assists. 3 days after the Challenge Cup, the Jacks would play the Beavers once again on October 16th in their first game of HPL League play for the month of October. The team would not see another league game for the next 10 days. On Friday, October 18th, the Lumberjacks were invited by the BCHL Langley Rivermen to their game against the Brooks Bandits for a ceremonial puck drop to celebrate their Challenge Cup win. Before the ceremony, the Brooks Bandits head coach told the team that his kid was on the HSL Warriors in the Challenge Cup. This was the team the Jacks played in their first game of the tournament. In a classy move, the coach then proceeded to praise the team and congratulated each kid. With the Vancouver Island Wolves in town, the Jacks and Wolves faced off on Saturday, October 26. With Gail unavailable, the team called up Shea Shelley and Hudson Wilkie from the 2016 team to bolster the lineup. As the game got started, it was discovered that two players on the Wolves were unavailable and had only 8 kids that could play. After the first period, Murray and Montaigne would volunteer to go over and play for the Wolves and give their kids a bit more bench time to catch their breath. The other Island team was also in town, so the Jacks and the Vancouver Island Surge played each other for the first time on October 27th. With head coach Randy Ponte out with a cold and Gail unavailable again, coaches Murray and Eckford guided the team to their 17th win of the season. For their third game in 3 nights, the Jacks took on the Flyers. 2016, Jackson Steele was brought into the lineup as Gale and Gooman were unavailable. The team had a strong game, particularly Murray finishing the night with 6 goals. The final game in the month of October was played against the Bulldogs. The coaches decided to experiment in this game, moving the entire defense corps to play forward and moving 4 forwards back to defense. This had mixed results, and by the third period, the kids had all been moved back to their regular positions. This marked the first time in 7 games the team did not put up more than 50 shots on the opposition net. And now, the top 10 plays of the month. 10. Nine. 8. Seven. Six. Five. Number 4. Number 3. Number 2. Number 1. The 2015 Lumberjacks would like to thank the following sponsors. And that concludes this month's recap. You have been watching the October edition of Logged In. This has been a 30 Wonger 30 production.